So Shannon, should Vegas try and trade for Deshaun?
Yeah, I think absolutely. If you don't have a top five, top seven quarterback, I think you should be in the running for Deshaun Watson. Skip, there's something that's been on my mind and been bothering me. Last week, I called you the night before and told you that I had some information about Deshaun. And we came on the show. And at about 6:30, top of the show, I said, Deshaun Watson, my sources tell me Deshaun Watson has asked the Texans for a trade. And this is just being broached, but this was they asked a couple of weeks ago. Now, Adam Schefter reported 20 minutes after me that Deshaun Watson had asked for a trade, basically saying that he's breaking the news, which I'd already
said. Oh, I see.
And I said, what transpired? That he wants to go to the Jets. He have a fondness for Robert Saleh. Everybody keeps saying, nah, it's the Jets and this and that. So what they're trying to do is they're trying to add egg, pulled pork to a hamburger that I've already made. It's still a hamburger. You're just adding condiments, trying to add to the story. Back to this. Absolutely, Skip. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't...
This report came from Chris Sims.
Yes.
Okay.
What transpired, Skip, and you said this yesterday, Sirianni, when he was talking during the press conference, the player. He said the player.
The New England, not Sirianni. I'll think of his name in a second.
But anyway, the new Casario. Said the player.
Yes.
He must have realized how it sounded in his head, because then he started saying Deshaun. It was too late.
Yeah.
You see him snatch down everything off his thing, and I'm referring everything to my agent, David Mugaletta.
Yeah.
But anyway, Skip, yes, they should. Skip, I just always got the impression that John Gruden wasn't as fond of Derek Carr. I don't know what it is, and I could be totally wrong, but it's just something about, he's good, but I don't really know if he can take me to where I need to go. I am making $10 million a year. I do have a $100 million contract, and we haven't been to the playoffs. So this can be viewed as a failure, Skip. For $30 million, and I ain't got nothing to show for it, and a lot of it has to do with his defense. They finished last, 24th and 30th, last 3 years.
Yep.
I Gus Bradley in the offseason.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, Skip, you look at it, Darren Waller is a top three tight end. They got Josh Jacobs, who made the Pro Bowl again, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep.
Henry Ruggs can fly. They got nice receiving core. Offensive line is solid. Yeah, Deshaun Watson will be a major player for them. And in this offense, it's the West Coast system. Skip, they'd be foolish not to try.
Okay. To the second point you just made, I agree with your first point, but second point, as we watched Hard Knocks a couple of years ago, as Gruden hit Oakland, they were on their way to Las Vegas. But I told you the same thing. I know John Gruden well enough to know not buying Derek Carr. I don't know why, but John is always tough on his quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
He's over tough. I don't know why, but it's very difficult to play quarterback for John Gruden.
Right.
See his history. He got Rich Gannon at age 36, and Rich, because I was there at the time, Rich would stand up to him and use the same language back to him.
Yeah, it's tough for a young guy.
And then he had Brad Johnson, who was 34, going on like 44, because it seemed like he'd been around forever.
Right.
But he won a Super Bowl with Brad Johnson.
Right.
Obviously not a great quarterback, more in the mold of a Trent Dilfer that you had.
Mm-hmm.
But Brad Johnson would say, no, John, I'm not going to take that from you, because I know how to play this position pretty well.
Right.
I've been doing it for a long time in Minnesota and other
in
places.
In Washington.
Yep. So it takes that kind of guy to stand up to John Gruden. So when I heard this idea, the first thing I thought was, poor Derek Carr. You know, he's pretty good. He actually had a career year last year.
He did.
For 4,100 yards. He was 27 touchdowns and 9 interceptions, completed 67%, had his best QBR by far of 71, which is pretty good, and Pro Football Focus ranked the 9th best quarterback. So he was ranked top 10 in overall grade. Okay, that's pretty good, but they went 8-8.
Right.
And I can't defend Derek on one count. That's only the second year he's had a non-losing record.
Right.
Because they did, under Jack Del Rio, your man, they went 12-4 that year, but he was hurt going to the playoff game at Houston. Remember that? And you know what happened.
Mm-hmm.
It was Connor Cook against Brock Osweiler, and they lost.
Right.
Okay? So Derek doesn't have much to show for his performance even last year. 8-8, not going to get it. So you know how Gruden and Mayock are. They're shoot the moon. They're going to plunge just like the Rams plunge.
They shove it all in,
right?
Too.
Okay, because they shoved it all in. They said, let's take a flyer on AB. Let's just see what happens. High risk, high reward, and it didn't work. So, to me, I will not at all be surprised if they go after Deshaun. This is just me. Maybe you could relay this to the camp. If I'm Deshaun,
you don't want to go there.
I'm not sure I would love this. I don't know what it is about John. He played a little bit of, wasn't it D2 quarterback?
Yeah.
Or, you know, where was it? At Akron or not at Akron. I'll think of it in a second. But he was, he was just kind of a, middle of the road, smaller college quarterback who got it in his head that he knows how to play the position better than anybody, the side of Tom Brady, right? And what was he known for at ESPN? The Gruden quarterback camp. So he'd bring him in, and he'd put those poor kids through the ringer, man. He would light fires under them, right?
And that was the thing, though, Skip, and you're absolutely right, is that
he played at Dayton.
He thinks that he, you got to do this. I get it. Look, Skip, he's a coach, and he's coached some he was on that staff with Mike Holmgren that had Favre, and he went to Philly with Andy, and then he became the Raiders head coach. And he is tough. He's not everybody's cup of tea. And
remember after Brad Johnson at Tampa, they went through, speaking to Chris Sims, he was one of them.
Yeah.
He was just like, I'll change him by the week.
Mm-hmm.
He couldn't find a quarterback.
No.
Right?
So, I don't know. But I think, Skip, you got to kick the tires. I don't know. I mean, you're hearing stories. They want two ones, two twos, and two top, your best defensive players. I mean, if I'm the 49ers, I'll give you nine. I'll give you next year's pick, Nick Bosa. But I'm not giving you Nick Bosa and Armstead and two number ones and two number twos because you didn't get the starting defensive player from the Rams.
Yep.
So if you want two ones, I'll give you two ones and Nick Bosa, Armstead, one of those guys. Give me Deshaun.
Okay. To me, in the end, it's so rare that a quarterback of this caliber.
Not at this age,
don't come available.
Not at this age.
Hey, because it's not like you're picking him first overall where you think he's Trevor Lawrence. Trevor Lawrence is good, but you don't know for sure. I know.
Right.
I've seen it.
Skip, normally when quarterbacks become available, you get them like Brady and you're 21.
Yeah.
You get them like Peyton Manning off a serious injury where there's only 10, 15% chance he plays. Or Drew Brees, there's a 5%. But you don't get 20.
Or Matthew Stafford where he is just completely worn out his welcome in Detroit where they've tried and tried for years and they finally say, let's just change scenery here.
But he's 33.
Yeah.
You don't normally get 25 and 26-year-old quarterbacks healthy.
Deshaun is entering his prime.
Yes, yes.
He's just entering.
Yes.
This is Super Bowls to be won right here.
He might not even be in his prime. He might be at the door of his prime, Skip.
I agree. No, I agree. So,
but the Raiders, Skip, and plus the Raiders, the jury is still out on Cleveland Farrell. They took him 3 overall. Okay, Josh Jacobs looked like a player.
I agree.
Henry Ruggs, we got to see. They got him to be Tyreek. That's what they got him to be, Skip. He's supposed to be that guy. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he can do anything other than run post to go route because you see what they do. Tyreek has turned himself into a receiver where he can catch the slant, he can catch the end cut, he can break out. He just doesn't run deep routes anymore.
Okay, well, ran one. It was your basic Hail Mary that beat the Jets.
Yeah.
But remember, it took that for the Raiders to beat the Jets.
Yeah.
Okay. So I would advise Deshaun to steer clear of this.
Well, he does have the leverage that he has, Skip, is that he does have a no trade. So you can say we want to trade here. Like, no, I don't want to go there.
Yep. It's like Matt Stafford said, I'll go anywhere but Belichick.
Yeah. And look, y'all already done screwed me over. Do me this solid.
Yep.
Do me this solid here in Texas.
There are a lot of great landing spots for him other than this. And, again, I'm a big Gruden fan. I told you from the start. I believe he can win a Super Bowl there. But he's going to have a quarterback. He needs a veteran
quarterback
who can put him back in his place and say, no, let's do it this way.
I would like to see Deshaun go to Denver because they got some weapons.
Yep.
But if he can't go to Denver, put him with Kyle Shanahan.
Okay.
Shanahan, Skip, it's over.
It would be over. They would win multiple Super Bowls.
I would agree. Yep.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.